How to troubleshoot a camera is disconnected system event. If you're seeing a camera is disconnected event in your health dashboard or from the health monitoring page, this indicates that the video unit is physically disconnected from the network or there is a software issue preventing the system from seeing the video unit. A video unit can either be an IP video camera that connects directly to the network or an IP video encoder which allows one or more analog cameras to connect to the network. The first three steps are required to check if it is a network or connection issue. Before checking anything else, make sure the internet connection at the client site is working properly. The next step is to verify the local network devices, such as the switch or router the video unit is connecting to. Finally, take a look at the physical connection to the video unit and make sure the network cable is connected and the video unit is powered on. If there is a problem with the network or a connection issue, the system events for this video unit should be removed from the event list, which is refreshed every 2 minutes. You can choose to receive emails for this system event and the equivalent camera reconnected event by placing a check mark in the Receive Camera Disconnected and Camera Reconnected notifications from your preferences. When the above steps do not resolve the issue, follow the next series of troubleshooting steps to verify if the problem is on the video unit or a software configuration issue. The first step is to connect to the web interface of the video unit and log on. You'll need to be on the client's network to do this, and you should be using the video unit's OAK or owner authentication key as the password. If the OAK contains any dashes or hyphens, omit them from the password and make sure all characters are typed in uppercase. The next step is to restart the video unit from the web interface. To do this, click on the Setup button, go to System Options, then Maintenance, and click on Restart. If the restart does not allow the video unit to connect, the next step is to follow the troubleshooting steps to configure the DNS server address on the video unit. Once the DNS settings have been verified, the next step would be to restore the server settings. The steps for doing so can also be found in the troubleshooting section of the online help guide or the YouTube channel. Before disconnecting from the client network, it would be a good idea to download the server report from the video unit's webpage in case further troubleshooting is required from the Stratocast support team. The steps for retrieving the file can be found in the online help guide and the YouTube channel as well. The last troubleshooting step would be to unplug the video unit, wait a few seconds, and plug it back in. The video unit may take a few minutes to come back online. If these steps do not allow the video unit to reconnect to Stratocast, please contact the Stratocast support team and send them the server report that we retrieved from the video unit. Remember that the health monitoring page and the health dashboard are updated every 2 minutes and may not reflect the change to the video unit state immediately.